Welcome to Neighbourshood this week. Man, that was very impressive.
That's my God, you're strong.
Oh, stop it. Calm down. Now, remember what I said at the beginning of the show? Go.
Sorry.
Go. This is your time. Go.
Hi, my name is Aaron.
Remember. Remember. The 6th of November. You can't remember one line. This is ridiculous. This show's gonna be terrible.
You told me to just stand there.
No, come on then. Off you go. Come on.
Okay, guys, we're going in 3, 2, 1. Time's up.
Oh, how's that? All right, it's question time. All right, Maddie Wilson, so your character this week has been over in Paris, which is super exciting.
It is.
What else have you seen in Paris?
I've seen...
Actually, you know what? Can you tell me what you've seen in mine? Eiffel Tower! French baguettes? Pretzels? What's round? Croissant.
Croissant.
Knocking on the green door. That's fantastic. Now, you actually went to Paris for the shoot, didn't you?
I did.
That's such an awesome experience, man. How was that?
It was unreal. Like, has anyone else ever in the history of Neighbours filmed in Paris?
No, they haven't.
Yeah.
I mean, they filmed a few kilometres away in London a few times, but not in Paris. What do you think could have been behind the green door?
I was looking for a lady called Louise, but actually whilst we were filming, I knocked on the door and some bloke who actually lived there came out and he was like, "What do you want?"
Are you serious? Yeah. He would have seen the whole cameras and everything.
I really haven't. I got a photo of it on my phone.
Oh, that's ridiculous. Your character, he's an entrepreneur. So he's been a gym owner, a bodyguard, a fashionista.
Exotic dancer.
A media person looking after, what's next?
To invent a dating app. Right, and it's like yin and yang, it's opposites attract, and it finds, you make a profile, I make a profile, and the people who have the most bizarre, like opposite end interests, get paired together. And all they do is get a time and a place, so 4 p.m, Harold's, and you rock up, and you see this other person there.
Wow, it sounds like it could lead to a lot of murders. If I was a yin, what would my yang look like?
Me.
Wow. All right, guys, you better go to set, because Matt and I just need to talk about something really serious just for a minute. We're at the school, we're here with our Lily Vandermeer, so I'm just shooting back at the school.
Yes.
What's this? You're back in your school uniform.
I am. I'm back to school. I'm repeating year 12 again.
What's your favourite subject?
Oh.
Come on, character work.
Character.
Come on, know thy character. Thy character is...
within.
Just pick one.
Hates everything.
Just pick one.
It's science.
Good pick. Looks like you're already getting expelled.
Yeah, I know. Something happens, it's the first week back, and she's already being accused of something, which obviously she didn't do.
Obviously, because you're just such a great person.
So I'm getting into trouble and I'm trying to defend my case and no one really believes me, which sucks.
You've got a very sus looking face.
Thank you.
Tell me something truthful.
I woke up really early this morning.
I don't believe a word of it. I don't believe it. We are a couple of studs. Welcome back to Neighbourshood. All right, put your butt. We're done. That's enough. No, you've done enough.
All right.
Welcome to the blindfold game. Now, you have been in Paris, we have already established, looking
yes.
for Hamish. We are gonna play a game called Ham or Ham-ish. So we've got a few things here and we are gonna see if you can guess them, okay?
Okay.
Now, do you mind if I touch them and then put them into your mouth, or do
touch
you
want to- Touch whatever you want.
Ham or Ham-ish?
Definitely not ham.
What is it?
It's Hamish.
Ham-ish. Ham or
Hamish?
Hamish.
Hamish.
Oh, Jesus. All right. It's really hard to feed you from this angle.
That, my friend, is ham.
Ham?
That's
good.
Ham.
Good. Yep. Perfect. Ham or Hamish?
Ham. What do you call everything? Ham.
A sandwich. A ham sandwich. No. All right, done. Okay.
How did I go?
Now, We actually didn't have any ham here. So we had beef, which you said was ham. Cheese, which obviously you guessed was not cheese. Mortadello, thought turkey was ham.
Yeah, look, I was the rim around the outside, that little...
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
You can't see, you felt that all in taste.
Yeah.
That's incredible. He's got the mouth buds, taste buds of a genius.
And you got the vocabulary of a genius?
Oh, cool. Well, whatever my vocabulary is, it's not trumped by yours, thank God. But we are going to go and see who is this week's cake taker.
Whoa!
Hi there.
Hello, mate.
I'm just pretending to drink a cup of coffee and check my emails.
Ooh, it is. Woohoo! This week I get to do the cake taker of the week.
Oh, no!
Yes.
What for?
Gaynorb74 says, about time, Rhodey. Keep it in your pants, love. I meant Toadie. Lol. I think
all
this
right.
is about Toadie and Sonia. They're going a bit OTT with the PDA.
What
do you think?
Well, you know, it's going well, actually. So, fine.
Do you think it's a bit OTT?
I do. And I love it. So I'm going to take my cake and eat it.
Haley says, I am little Callum now that Toadie and Sonia are constantly sucking face and cringe flirting.
Nah, take it, Callum and Haley.
Can you cringe flirt with me sometimes?
I cringe flirt with you all the time, mate. You just don't pay any attention. You don't love me the way I love you.
After the break.
I'm doing it! I'm doing it! Hey! Hey, don't... Oh, nuts. This is ridiculous. How am I supposed to do a bloody TV show with you looking like this and me not being able
just
to...
Chill. It'll come. It'll come.
I want it to come instantly. Isn't there some kind of fast-tracked way that you could instantly make me fit and instantly make me good at all kinds of gym equipment?
2 week free session.
2 week free sessions? Not quick enough. You know you should never unbalance a man when he's doing weights. I was fine. You didn't need to. Woo. Woo.
I know this just seems like fun and games, but this is can actually hurt you, mate.
Yeah, no, I'm good though. Well, looks like we're at the end of Neighbourshood. Thanks for joining us, Maddie. Aaron.
Yeah, that's all right. I think we might need to go see the doctor.
I'll be sweet.
Carl.
Oh, Dr. Sure. Carl, we'll go see Dr. Carl. Yeah, I could get a bit of Dr. Loving. Hey, what's coming up for Aaron? In the show?
I don't know.
Love triangles?
We've got a couple of... Aaron goes over to Paris.
Mm-hmm.
And he's not just looking for Louise and trying to dig up dirt on Hamish. Something else happens. A spanner in the works.
Ah, very good.
A big, tall, beautiful gentleman creates a love triangle.
Very good.
It's an equilateral triangle.
Can you give us a name?
Well.
Rory.
All right, guys, that's the end of Neighbourshood. Thank you, Matt Wilson, for joining us. It's been an absolute pleasure.
Thank you, Ben.
Make sure you guys are tuning in next week. Huge storylines. Someone is going to die next week. One of Ramsey Street's favourite daughters is going to go missing. Maddie just said there's a new love interest on their way for him.
Mm.
And Tyler is finally going to discover the truth about Hamish. Thanks, guys. We'll see you next week.
Bye. Gary Getting, aka Damien Richardson. You know, click here if you want to watch more Q&As and hear the backstage videos. Go on, do it now. You know you want to. I'm waiting. I'll still be here.